Hey guys, this is Eddie the Magic Monk. Welcome to another technology tutorial. Today we're going to talk about how to make a screen capture video tutorial like the one that I'm making for you guys right now. And you guys probably have seen a lot of my maths tutorials and they're made using the same way. The first thing I need to mention is that right now I'm on Windows 7, so all of this stuff will probably only work for Windows 7. If you have Windows 8 or something, then some of this stuff probably won't work. I'm going to get Windows 8 pretty soon, so I'll try to update this Prezi in case anything doesn't work for Windows 8. But let's get started. The first thing you need to do is make sure that you have the right equipment. Now these are the things that you need, the hardware. Okay, the first thing you need to buy is a microphone. Now a lot of things have a microphone attached to it already these days. For example, if you have a laptop, it might already come with a microphone. So if you have one already, test it out, see if you like the quality. A more expensive microphone will usually give you better quality, and I highlight the word usually. Second thing you need is a webcam. If you want to show your face like what I'm doing now, then you need to get a webcam. Some people don't want to show their faces, so therefore you don't need a webcam if you don't want to show your face. Third thing you need to buy is a tablet. Now that's for drawing and writing stuff on the screen. So if you want to make maths tutorials like the ones that I'm making, then you almost certainly need a tablet. Okay, so let's keep going with this. Now, what are some different microphones you could buy? Well, the microphone that I'm using right now is Blue Snowball, and I'll just hold it up so you guys can see it. Now, what I find with the Blue Snowball is that it is a little bit quiet, so you might want to buy the better version, which is the Blue Yeti. But I'll leave that up to you guys to decide. There are also quite a lot of other Blue microphones you can look at on their website. Logitech also has some pretty good microphones, and they're mostly headsets, which means you wear them around your head so that the sound is clearer, and you could try them if you like. Okay, let's keep going. Webcam. Now the webcam that I'm using right now is a Logitech C210. Now the quality, as you can see on the screen, is not that high. If you want a better quality one, you probably need to spend a bit more money. My webcam is only worth probably about $20 to $30. You can buy a lot more expensive ones that will probably give you better quality, and I'm not sure if there are any other webcams that are better than Logitech, but you're welcome to do your own research as well. Okay, so if you want to draw on the screen, you almost certainly need a tablet. Don't try to draw with the mouse. It's going to be very difficult, and your writing will probably look pretty ugly if you just draw with a mouse. Now, what kind of tablet should you get to draw on the screen? Well, the one that I'm using is a Wacom Bamboo tablet, which looks like this. So probably can't see it very well on a webcam, but there's your Wacom Bamboo tablet. And depending on the size of your tablet, it could cost anything from $100 to a few hundred dollars. And Bamboo tablet is actually the outdated version, so Wacom has released a better version called the Intuos tablet. So do your own research on which tablet you should buy. Okay, so if you have those three things, then you're ready to move on to the next section. Okay, the next section, what we need to do is buy or download the software that you need for everything to work. The first thing you need is screen capture software, then you need the desktop webcam software, like the one that I'm using right now to show my webcam. You need drawing software, and then you need video editing software. So let's go through them one by one. Screen capture software. What I'm using right now to record the screen is called Bandicam. As you can see right now, it says that I'm recording this right now, and this is the sound, the volume of the sound that I'm speaking into my microphone at. And Bandicam is free, but it will show up with a watermark on the top of your video, a very small watermark showing the link of their website. If you don't want that watermark, then you need to pay for it, which is about $39 US. Hypercam is free, Cam Studio is free. Camtasia costs money. It's probably the most expensive one, but it is probably the best one as well. And Jing is free, but I believe you can only record for 5 minutes. So try them out, see which one suits you the best. Okay, next. Webcam software. So the software that I'm using right now to show this webcam on the screen, as you can see, I can drag this around. It's called Camdesk. Now, I believe A7W Cam does the same thing. And Logitech webcam software, that's for recording this webcam separately. Now, you probably use that if you were recording a game or something like that. The most famous gaming channel on YouTube, PewDiePie, I believe, uses Logitech webcam software to record the webcam. Okay, so that's the webcam software. Drawing software, what you need for drawing things on the screen. Now, all of these programs do the job. SmoothDraw is free if you want to just download that. And that's, I believe, used by Khan Academy as well. So when you see that the screen is all black and they're drawing with all different colors, then that's most likely SmoothDraw. OneNote works pretty well for me, except it doesn't do the black background thing, and it's a bit harder to pick the colors for the pens. But the good thing about OneNote is that you get to keep everything you write inside it automatically, whereas with SmoothDraw, well, I've pretty much lost all the originals for my tutorial videos. So whereas with OneNote, it's all just saved automatically. So that's what's good about OneNote. And Paint is what was originally used, I believe, by Khan Academy, if you want to try doing that. Okay, next, video editing software. Now, fortunately, I have Adobe Premiere Pro, which is, I believe, the best one out there. There's also Sony Vegas, which I've never used, and Windows Movie Maker, which I think is probably going to be a bit outdated, but I'm not sure. I don't use that. Okay, so once you have all the software, then you can go ahead and start recording the video. First step to recording is display your webcam on your desktop. So you need to run the Camdesk software, get this webcam up, and then you're gonna re start recording the screen with Bandicam. So if I click stop, what will happen is the record button shows up. So click here to record. You also need to choose your target. So you can choose to record the whole screen or record a section of the screen. So click record and just see that it works. Okay, see if the file is generated, watch the video, see if it works. If it doesn't, if it does work, then go ahead and record a longer video, right? The last thing you want to do is spend half an hour recording something that doesn't even work. And then once it's all recorded, if you need to, then you can import videos into Premiere Pro to edit them or put an intro, outro on it or something like that. And then of course the last thing you do is uploading the video onto YouTube. Now just keep in mind you need a YouTube or a Google account to do that, and be careful when they ask you if you want your full name on your YouTube channel, because that is public. So if you don't want your full name to be public, then just be careful with what it's asking you to do. Okay, thanks for watching, guys. Hope you learned something from this tutorial. See you guys next time.